Hello, how are you doing? Thank you. Welcome, my name is Rechael Mbugwa. Thank you for subscribing on my YouTube channel, Heart Heart Clinic. But if you haven't, please click the red button below here and thank you for your support. Today we are looking at reason why people work for company for a long time. And by long time, I mean 6 years and above. Staying in a millennial in a company for more than 2 years is so uncommon nowadays. This leaves us wondering, what are the reasons that makes employees work for long in a company? When employees start looking for a new job, it's always a sign that they're unhappy. Happy employees will drive the company to success by boosting team productivity and loyalty. In our today's world, companies have two different impressions. Customers' impression and employees' impression. Just as they so say, customer is the king. I don't know whether they also say that employees are the queen, because they make the king. I don't know. But nowadays, when you get in, you'll be able to know that customers have a different impression with employees concerning the same company. So let's look at the reason why people work in a company for a long time. One, benefit and incentives. These include a great work independence, development opportunities, healthcare, commuting allowances, and performance bonuses. Think about it. Were your employees so concerned on how you're going to go home even after working late? Where you know your manager will not micromanage you getting to know what is it that you're doing? When you get to know that when I started working for this company, this has been my growth plan. These are the benefits and incentives that helps employee work and stay in a company for a long time. Number two, satisfaction with the environment. At this, we are looking at the environment that they are working in. Is it clean? Is it a peaceful one? Are they always happy? Do they have ample space? Or are they squeezing themselves in the available space? Sufficient of facilities that they are able to use? What is their morale? Are they motivated? Dealing with accountable people, then they are not dealing with losses or thieves in that particular. Opportunity even to socialize and even to interact with the rest. What is it that the system they are working in, is it supportive? Is it harassing them? Now, having all this environment very satisfaction, it encourages people to work for a company for a long time. Number three, financial composition. Where you get a good pay, and you are rendered for your bonuses or incentives when you do well. Who won't mind stability? In this case, you're looking for a permanent and pensionable kind of a job, that every day you're secured of a job. True, you may have option of looking for greener pasture, but when a company gives you that leeway that you'll be able to know it is a sustainable, it is permanent, unless you want to change, here is home. This becomes a motivation that they can be able to work for a company for a long time. Let's look for another reason why people work for a company for a while. Inspiration for working smart. You've had instances where performance is calculated based on how long you've been in the office, and you see you're not able to balance your work, your home, and the transport hours that you spend. So you find people overworking or overstaying in the office but do not equate to productivity in the workplace. So inspiration to work smart means encouraging people to work based on the duties given, not based on the hours. That the fact that the company has said you have to work for 8 hours doesn't mean staying in the office for 8 hours or longer makes you a better employee. So this will strive to get them to achieve the daily goals they have set their target, and they also build a relationship that gives a harmonious workplace environment. Number five, challenges and excitement. People like to be challenged in their area of expertise, then knowing that they have grown. One day they were doing system development, another time they're developing a new software to do something great. Getting to be challenged in your area of expertise bring excitement and getting to know I'm learning and I'm growing, and this project brings dynamics in a well-balanced terms of motivation. And number six, mentorship. Learning from more experienced people from a company makes this easier, or even getting to know new and less experience getting to know new things that you never knew about it. This helps polish new employees to be able to grow from where they were to a new level. Mentorship conducted in a learning environment brings a hands-on kind of an approach where people get to know even if so-and-so is not present, work will still proceed. Number 7, appreciation and recognition. Who doesn't want to be recognized? So companies that only recognize one person, really, year after year, year after year, they bring demotivation in a company that is already predicted, it's already known that it is so-and-so who is going to be awarded this year. It is so-and-so who will be put in a PIP or a performance program where they've not performed based on the set target. But when you appreciate all of them and be able to recognize that them that are working hard, they have a pay, you bring a harmonious environment that people look forward to work for such a company. Number 8 is a career development. Most employees do not want to be stuck in a dead end job where they have no growth, there is no advancement, they are doing the same year come in, year go. That's the same thing they are doing. It brings boredom, monotony. But being able to be engaged in different area, getting to know that I'm having a new challenge, my career is growing. I started here in a diploma. I did my degree. Now I'm doing my master's. There is a growth in career. It also brings people to motivation that they can be able to work for that company. Another thing that motivates people is work-life integration. Most of the people would say work-life balance, but let me bring a concept of integration. Integration is where you cannot be able to balance life in this aspect where you have a set 24 hours in a day that you know, I will sleep for 4 hours, take care of my children for 4 hours, work for 4 hours, so that you can be able to equate everything that is on your table to equally distributed hours. It is not possible. First, because working hours is automatically 8 hours. Sleeping hours, 8 hours. Do you want to tell me you spent hours in traffic for 8 hours to have a balanced life? Or you spent 8 hours with your family to have a balance of work, life, and family? No. You have to integrate them. That you get to know you have a nursing mom. She feels comfortable that she can be able to rush and nurse the baby and still be able to attend their work. Whether they will do it online or they have a baby crush where they can be able to bring their children, it is more of a work-life integration and harmony. This brings commitment and the employee getting to know that their personal well-being is well taken care of by the company. It is also an assuring that getting to know my children are not struggling out here and they're not struggling outside there, yet I cannot get even a permission to go to attend to them. Getting to know that everything else is well integrated. Someone is taking care of my children, they're in school, I'm here taking care of the work that I've been assigned. It brings a lot of purpose, excitement, and even loving to be associated with such a company that takes care of them. Participating in something special. This is the last thing, but when a company can retain employees, when they develop a harmonious culture that will bring people to work together or to get engaged along. For instance, they may take a project that us as a water company, we want to give back to the community. But the way we are going to give back to the community is our allowing our employee to be part of it. Can we touch on education? What is it can we do on education? We can create library in a slum, or we can create schools, or we can give scholarship. When we allow the employees and the community to do something special towards the same community they are living in, you bring a lot of excitement for someone to work for such a company because it gives them the purpose that we are not only generating money, we are not only making product, we are also concerned with the community. What else can they do for community? Health, building a hospital, supplying lady with sanitary towels, doing project that can buy them machines that can help them operate better in a hospital. Building resource center. These are like maybe building a borehole that will help the youth make a car wash or sell that water or generate income or even help the elderly in an elderly home, even children home. So there are various aspects that a company can do something special involving both their employees and the community that they serve. These are the things that make people work for a company for a long time. a sense of belonging, a sense that they are valued, a sense that they matter, and in all this, you are able to receive, to achieve the company objective of making money, taking care of employee, as well as taking care of your company, of your customers, and the community around them. This is Heart Clinic with Rechael Mbugwa, helping you understand why people would work for long in a company. See you next time. Bye-bye.